under that high-stakes gamble for President Trump, agreeing to meet face-to-face with Kim Jong-un. Any reward from this, of course, also comes with great risk. Tonight, what the White House is now saying about this face-to-face meeting, of course, amid high tensions with North Korea, and questions here at home about whether the President of the United States and the North Korean dictator should be seen together, should Kim Jong-un be elevated to the same stage. ABC's chief White House correspondent Jonathan Carl tonight with what he's just learned.
The president was ecstatic, poking his head into the White House briefing room to announce that something big was about to happen, and then telling ABC News, "I hope you give me credit." Minutes later, the South Koreans revealed the surprise message from Kim Jong-un.
He expressed his eagerness to meet President Trump as soon as possible.
Kim's invitation included a promise to pause nuclear and missile tests and to accept that U.S. troops will continue joint military exercises with the South. The White House seemed to accept the offer with no strings attached, saying simply the president will accept the invitation to meet with Kim Jong-un at a place and time to be determined. But today, the White House suggested there are now other preconditions.
Does he think that Kim Jong-un can be trusted as a negotiating partner?
Look, we're not in the negotiation right now. We've accepted the invitation to talk based on them following through with concrete actions on the promises that they've made.
According to the press secretary, the North Koreans have promised something big, denuclearization.
They've promised to denuclearize, they've promised to stop nuclear and missile testing, and they've recognized that we're going to continue in our military exercises. This meeting won't take place without concrete actions that match the promises that have been made by North Korea.
It's unclear exactly what those concrete actions are or how they would be verified. No sitting president has ever met with a leader of North Korea. And before yesterday's surprise announcement, the idea seemed virtually unthinkable, coming after a year of escalating tensions, including North Korea's most powerful nuclear and missile tests. The rhetoric has been red hot.
North Korea best not make any more threats to the United States. They will be met with fire and fury like the world has never seen.
Rocket Man is on a suicide mission for himself and for his regime.
Kim has called Trump mentally deranged and an old lunatic. Trump has called Kim a maniac, a madman, and a sick puppy. But last year, the president also described Kim as a, quote, smart cookie. And tonight, the next step in their relationship, to be determined.
So let's get to John Carl. He's live at the White House tonight. And John, even with Sarah Sanders talking about those preconditions today in the briefing, your sources inside the White House tonight telling you that they are very much planning to move forward with this meeting?
A senior White House official, David, just told me there are, in fact, no new preconditions, no promise on denuclearization from the North Koreans. That the policy that was announced last night remains. The only promises from the North Koreans are they will stop for now their nuclear tests and their missile tests. They will accept those joint military exercises with the U.S. and South Korea. Officials here, David, are fully expecting and planning for a meeting with Donald Trump and Kim Jong-un.
All right, John Carl at the White House.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.